In this tutorial, we will briefly go over the new Windows 8 user interface, and how to use the Start Screen and Charm Bar to accomplish the same tasks we used to perform with the old Windows Start menu. This is a major change to the core way in which users have grown accustomed to using Windows since the introduction of the Start menu with Windows 95. This tutorial should be perfect for any user who is new to Windows 8 and wants to quickly learn the new Windows 8 interface. Instead of Windows loading to the desktop as it did in the past, it now loads to the Start Screen. The new Start screen instead presents you with dynamic tiles for the installed applications that have been created as Windows 8 apps. These were formerly known as Metro apps. Applications written to run on versions of Windows previous to 8, such as Vista or 7, will still run perfectly as a Windows 8 desktop application. The apps that show up here are designed to run across desktops, laptops, tablets, smartphones, and even the new Xbox One. To get to the desktop, you can either click the double-wide desktop tile, or by using the keyboard shortcut of the Windows key plus D. When on the desktop, you can open the Start screen by clicking the Start button, or if you prefer, you can just press the Windows key on the keyboard. If we open a Windows 8 app like Maps, you will notice that it takes up the entire screen, and it's not launched on the traditional Windows desktop. To close out any Windows 8 app, you need to move your mouse to the top center of the screen until you see the small hand icon. You then click and drag to the bottom of the screen and release. If you don't want to close out the Windows 8 app completely, but you do want it to run in the background, you can click in the top center of the screen, and then drag to the left side of the screen, and dock it. With this being the last app open, it leaves the bar open so that you can select a previous running app, or you can click the Start button to return to the Start screen. To start a previously launched app, you can hold your mouse at the bottom left of the screen until you see the Start button, and then drag the mouse up and select the app. Clicking the Start button here will open the currently running Windows 8 app screen. Let's close this out. You can also have two Windows 8 apps open at the same time. To do this, open up whatever application you want for your first app. We will open the Calendar app. Then this time, we'll bring the mouse to the top center of the screen. But instead of dragging from the top to the bottom to close it out, we drag down and either to the left side or the right side to dock the application. Now one part of the screen is blank. Clicking in the blank space that shows up on the opposite side of the screen that you open the app will open back up the Start screen. The next Windows 8 app that you open will dock to the other side. We will click Photos. If you'd look between the two open apps, there is a bar with three dots in the center that separate the open apps. To start off with, both apps open with each taking up half of the screen. We can set custom sizes by clicking on the separation line and releasing anywhere that it snaps. Let's go back to the Start screen. The default Start screen only contains the most commonly used apps. We can show all the other applications installed by clicking this down arrow icon. We will now see all the other applications installed on the system. If all the apps did not show up on the single screen, there would be a scroll bar horizontally at the bottom of the screen. We'll see Windows 8 apps at the beginning, as well as Windows Accessories, Windows System, and other categories and applications. We can also see any applications that we ourselves installed on the system, such as the WinDirStat application that I installed here. In addition to opening the application, we can right-click on the item once. This will place a check on the right side of the tile, and will open a new menu at the bottom of the window with tasks that are specific to the tile application. Let's right-click on WinDirStat to test. By selecting the WinDirStat application tile I have installed on this system, we can see the standard list of options. Pin to start. This option will add the select application to the base start screen, without having to right-click and select all apps on the toolbar. Pin to taskbar. This option will add the selected application to the taskbar on the traditional Windows desktop. Uninstall. This option will open Windows Programs and Features to allow you to run through the uninstall utility. Open New Window. This will open the application on the Windows desktop, and it is essentially the same as left-clicking on the application to open it. Run as Administrator. This option will open the application to the desktop, but instead of running it as the user you're currently logged into the computer as, it will run the application with the permissions from the administrator account on the computer. Open File Location. This will open a Windows Explorer view of the shortcuts from the start screen used to launch the application. Find in Start. This will search the Start menu. You can deselect the item by clicking anywhere on the screen. Let's click to select Pin to Start. The Start screen will open with a newly pinned app on the far right. Let's go over the Windows Store. You can still download and install legacy Windows applications, like you have in previous versions of Windows, but you can now also use the Windows Store to download and install Windows 8 apps. When the Windows Store is first opened, the store will show spotlight items on the left. In the top right, you can search for the name of the app or enter a category or search term. At the bottom of the screen is a horizontal scroll bar that can be used to navigate through the Windows Store. The store is separated into categories that can be used to browse. Make sure that you pay attention to the cost of apps, if any. It will either list a price or show free. Let's click on the top free category to browse further. We can move back by clicking on the back arrow button. When we find an app that we want to install, we will click to open the details screen. Review the details, and then click the install button. The new app will show up under the Additional Apps section in the Start screen. If we want to rearrange the order of any of the icons on the screen, we can simply click, hold, and drag to another location. Upon releasing, it will snap into place. We can also readjust the size of any of the tiles if we want. We do this by right-clicking on one of the tiles and clicking Resize. We then have the option of wide, medium, or small. Let's open the Windows desktop. Click the desktop icon. To complement a new start screen, Windows has added a new menu called the Charm Bar. The Charm Bar is a universal toolbar in Windows 8 that can be accessed from anywhere no matter where you are. There are two ways to open the Charm Bar. The first option is to move your mouse to the bottom right of the screen. You see the Charm Bar open to the right. The second option is to use the keyboard shortcut, which is the Windows key plus C. Using the keyboard shortcut keeps the menu open until you select an option or click outside of the bar. There are five primary options in the Windows 8 Charm Bar. Search. Windows 8 has consolidated all your searching needs together in the search function on the Charm Bar. Everywhere, as this implies, searches all the below categories. Settings. This will search through the various system settings only. Files. This searches through the files on your computer and any online connected storage like SkyDrive. Web images will start a web search for images, and web videos will start a web search for videos. Share. The Share menu will open a custom list of ways to share currently open Windows apps. If we had the Map app open, we would see a list giving us the option to share this map using the Mail People or Reading List apps. The list here is going to be different depending on what apps you have installed on your computer. Here we currently only have the option to share this screenshot using Mail. Start. This will open the Start screen from wherever you're at. Devices. This option allows you to send the current screen data to another monitor, a printer, a phone, or another connected device. It only shows devices connected to the computer and ready to accept the screen data. Settings. The settings interface will open on the right side of the window. The available options will vary depending on whether you open this from a desktop, start screen, or another app. Let's go through the options in the settings screen. Control panel. This opens the control panel that we're all familiar with from Windows 7. Personalization. This opens the personalization window where you can change things like the desktop background, colors, and sounds. PC info. This opens the Windows System window. Here we can view information about the system and change additional settings. Help. This opens the Windows Help and Support window. The bottom of the settings screen allows you to view the networks the system is connected to. Adjust the volume, adjust the screen brightness, adjust the time between notifications, and change keyboard settings. One of the options you'll probably be looking for first in Windows 8 is going to be how to turn it off or restart it. Here we can see the power option. By clicking on it once, we'll have two additional options to either shut down the system or to restart. The removal and replacement of the Start menu with the Start screen and the charm bar will take a bit of getting used to. But if you give Windows 8 a chance, you just might find that you like it.